Warning, this podcast contains guns. Whole cache of them.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the As Seen on TV podcast for Arrow, Season 5, Episode 14, Sin Eater, The Sin Eater. I'm your host, Cleo. With me, I have Dom and Rachel. And, Dom, you're wrong. It wasn't a cache of guns. It was a cache of money.
Well, I thought there were guns in there. I thought it was money and guns.
No, their plan was to take the money and buy all the guns they needed to take over the city.
Oh. I could have sworn there were guns in there. Thought it was just under the money.
No, there was like 15 giant duffel bags full of money.
All the moolah.
Yeah, all the muns.
It was a cache of cash.
It was a cache of cash. Exactly. So we have our trio of ladies, which I liked very much.
They're all nuts.
It's great.
Their whole escape was brilliant.
Yeah, but they also got, like, stupid guards, so, like, it wasn't necessarily that it was brilliant, it was just, these guys are stupid.
The guards may as well be working at Gotham at this point, so.
Right. Yeah.
Gotham Asylum.
They're about as effective as the police force over there.
What I thought was weird is I've actually seen it inside of one of those, you know, transportation buses, and where the aisle is, there's a door, a locked door. They can't, they have no interaction. They can't walk freely in between. So I thought that was a little weird. I'm like, where is the locked door cage in between the two?
Conveniently not there.
Yeah, just conveniently not there.
Yeah. But yeah, it was Liza who, was that the beginning of the season or last season? That was last season, right? Because it was before we knew Quentin was working with Dark.
Yep.
And I actually did remember her as soon as the episode started. I think her and a couple other cops were like, they were dirty, they were like stealing drugs and money from the evidence locker.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
So it was Liza.
She was kind of twisting things, you know what I mean? She was like, the way things were and the way they actually were. She was twisting. I was like, she was twisting them in her head.
Yeah, I mean, she felt
justified.
Yeah, and she also felt lied to. Because she saw, she in the end of that episode that she was in last season, she gave herself up willingly. She's like, okay, what I did was bad. I'll go to jail. I'll get out. I'll live my life. But then she sees, Quentin was working with, like, a mass murderer, and she's like, oh, fuck that!
But, it's like, what? Someone else, like he said, someone else's sins, you can't cover them up with yours. It's just kind of, it's not a trade.
No, yeah, exactly.
There's no trade in that.
But with her is Chyna White, which was so, I loved seeing her again. It's been so fucking long.
It's been so long, I honestly don't even remember. Like,
really?
It's what?
Oh, season, I remember.
Like, Ryan!
What was this season what?
It was season 1 and 2!
Yeah, that's what I mean. Jeez. No, because when I was trying to catch up on the show, to be honest, like, the show was already in season 3 when Flash came out, and I don't think I caught up on this show until the Flash crossover. So, I blew through seasons 1 through 3 really fast. So I barely remember them, to be honest. And I also wasn't liking the show at that point. Season 1 really kind of turned me off. So I kind of blocked it out of my memory.
Yeah, it was just a little, like, I loved Chyna White, though. She was such a badass.
Yeah, she's a very good character. She's in a lot of other shows, the actress. I just like, they're like, Chyna White, didn't you put her in jail? He was like, a couple of times.
Okay, yeah, many times.
Many times. Just a couple of times, that's all. This time it kind of stuck.
Yeah, we'll see.
I still can't stand the redhead. Oh my god, she's so cringe.
I know, and I love it.
I'm glad they didn't.
Pun intended.
Yeah, she did. She didn't get as crazy as she normally does, I guess.
Well, they did focus,
The focus wasn't on her, so.
I was expecting her to say some kind of catchy, free thing, something to Ollie as the Arrow when they're fighting them or something.
Yeah.
I was waiting for it.
Me too. I mean, I even expected her to say something witty to the guys they were beating up and killing, but she never did. Like, I don't know. She kind of played straight Arrow.
The only thing she said was when she took was taking the Arrow. She goes, "These things are expensive."
Yeah, that was funny.
That was about it. But yeah.
Yeah, and at first when they were talking about the arrows that were like the green arrows that were like framing, I thought that they were referring to her arrows.
Oh.
And I was really confused for a minute, and then they clarified it when they talked about who exactly, you know, Felicity's boyfriend, I can't remember his name.
Billy.
When they clarified and they were talking about him, I was like, "Oh. Yeah, that's a problem."
Yeah. Oh yeah. No, as soon as they took the urgent envelope to the police chief, I was like, "Oh, we in trouble now." I didn't know that that's what that was.
Yeah.
That they were going to go try and arrest the Arrow, but I knew it was bad. Because they didn't show it to us, and he's like, you know, assemble, you know, not assemble the team.
But also, I think they both were doctored. We know that the one that was given, the official one, was doctored. And I think the one that the police chief, whatever he is, was doctored too, because we never mentioned that Billy was gay, you know, he was gagged, bound. And if you knew that in advance, I think things would have been different.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he wasn't get the detective, the captain wasn't getting the full story about what happened.
Either way, yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
But Ollie immediately, you know, looks at the, and I thought he recognized the handwriting.
At first,
that's what I thought it was, but it was just that it was from Opal City, like that was the giveaway. Because they went to Prometheus's mother's house.
I love that you use quotations around Prometheus's mother.
Because we're still not sure.
Sure.
It's even, you know, what? The son. Okay.
No,
for
I know.
All we know, it could be her. It could be the, you know, the mother.
What if it's Prometheus? Okay, this is just a thought. Totally, like, woo, throwing spaghetti at a wall, scene of the sticks. What if, you know, she's talking about how she hasn't seen her son since then. You know, they don't really have this really good conversation, you know. What if the DEA is her son?
I like that.
Cleo just flipped the table.
Flip it.
I mean, we never thought about that before. I mean, what if he is her son? Because he kind of came out of nowhere.
And there's something about there's something about him wanting to cover up the circumstances of Billy's murder. That made me think that he wasn't vigilante, because I know we were all on board with thinking the DA was vigilante. Uh-huh. But when he offered to cover it up, I'm like, that doesn't seem like something vigilante would do.
Right? And, I mean, and what better way to get revenge on the guy who killed your dad, but to get close to him? And he knew everything. As the DA, he knows everything already. You know what I mean? And he has easy access to all this information and stuff. So it's a possibility.
It is. And I like that. We haven't thought of that before.
But I mean, even if he's not, if he is still the vigilante, not Prometheus, I had another thought. I was like, well, what if, like, the captain guy, because of everything that played out?
What? Captain Pike? What about him?
What if he has some kind of role in this? He's working with Prometheus. Because how else would the news station get that information? Because there was only one person.
No, I know, but here's the thing. I don't think that, and we're going all over the place, and that's okay.
I'm sorry.
I don't think that it definitely came from the chief, right? Because the mayor comes to you and is like, we covered this up. And the chief is like, okay, let me arrest these guys and then expose you for fucking, you know, for fraud and what could probably be classified as high treason.
Right.
But, so it's definitely him, but I don't think it has anything to do with Prometheus. I think it's just, I'm doing my job because you told me you falsified documents, so now I have to tell other people.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm starting not to like him. I was giving him a fair shake, and I was giving him all, you know. I'm starting not to like him.
The DA? Wait, I'm...
No, Captain Pike, whatever his fuck's name
is. Oh, yeah. No,
I'm starting not to like him.
I think he's fine. He's shown us really no reason to not trust him.
Yeah, I mean, based on the information he had to go with this episode, I don't blame him, you know, at all. And this is just Prometheus's games.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
So, I mean, the only thing that we did learn from the visit to Prometheus' son's mother is that her son is still alive.
Yes.
That's the only thing that we know for a fact now, you know, from...
Well, the last time she saw him was 4 years ago.
Yeah.
Right.
So, yeah. Mm-hmm. I was trying to look at her house, see if there was, like, any pictures or something in the background, but I didn't see anything.
That house is a set on another show, and I couldn't figure out what it was, but it 100% is a set on another show.
So it's gotta be Flash or Supergirl or Legends.
You know, it might be Flash.
It might be Flash when his child. It kind of look like
his child. Yes, I think that's his childhood home.
It kind of look like, yeah. I did watch enough to know that much.
Because I said to my mom, I was like, wait, is this the house in Grimm? And she's like, no, it's not. I was like, damn it, it looks like it. Yeah, anyway, we don't really know what the mother knows, if she knows anything.
All I know is that
she was kind of like,
off.
Yeah, she's like, my son can do what he wants, fuck off.
Right?
But they got like a shit ton of data from the house computers.
One terabyte?
Yeah.
Who knows what she's adding?
Yeah. So that's that. I don't know. I guess we'll fucking find out more. Oh, but there was something in the promo for the next episode. There was something that Vigilante said that is another reason why I think maybe the DA is not Vigilante.
Okay.
But he said something where it sounded like it went against something that
the DA
the DA has said before. Mm-hmm. And now I'm mad I didn't write it down.
Mm. Yeah, right?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, so if my spaghetti theory works, that would, wow.
The spaghetti theory. Your Peter Pan theory.
The DA is the son, the bastard of what's his face. That's basically what.
Mm. Yeah. So the ACU is going after the Green Arrow, and for like a good 20-30 minutes of the episode, Ollie was like, "There's nothing I can do." And I'm yelling at the screen, you have 4 other team members who can do a shit ton of stuff while you're sitting on your ass, Ollie!
Yeah.
And I'm just like, you have a team for this reason! Like, send the team! Oh, I was just so frustrated with that.
Well, then again, he has that where he feels like he doesn't want to get, you know, he just feels like it's all on him. Because these are people that
he
just like
feels that way.
Just like Quentin felt the same, you know, when what's her face.
That's true.
I can't remember.
This is my responsibility.
Yeah. This is a little bit that
Ollie could be in charge of a 100-man army, and it's still all his fault, and it's still all on him.
Yes.
Yep. Sure. He has a lot of guilt about shit. Mm-hmm. And he just needs to build a bridge and get over some of this shit, because it's not worth, you know, stunting your life over it, some of this stuff.
Yeah. So Brian in chat is saying this episode made me think that Thea is Prometheus.
Mm.
She was mysteriously gone for a while.
Well, I did write that down. Uh-huh. Sure. Yeah, I did write that down. I was like, in this episode, she was acting really weird. Like, she repeated like what Anatoly told Ollie.
Yeah.
I didn't think too much of it, but
you're right.
And it is weird because when she was gone, Prometheus was really active. But now that she's back, he's not.
Right.
So either she knows who he is or something. I don't know. Something's up. Mm. She's acting really weird. And obviously, Ollie has figured out that she is acting weird, because at the end of the show, he was just like, I'm worried about you.
Yeah.
Because she's, I mean, it's not against her nature to do what she did to Susan, which I don't care. I thought it was funny. But at the same point, it's kind of against her not to tell Ollie what she found. Because she's always been kind of like, hey, yo, I found this kind of thing.
And it's not even the thing that made me think. It wasn't that she didn't tell Ollie. It's that it was a stupid fucking plan. And then she's like, well, I didn't know she was going to get fired. Oh, you didn't know she was going to get fired?
Yes, she did.
Yeah, she did. She knew.
You know, exactly. But like I said, you didn't know that was going to happen.
Well, and also when we first saw her back, she said something about him going to Russia. Oh, you know, there's our flyer miles. What if she was there too?
Doing what?
I don't know. I mean... I don't know. She was acted really kind of weird. Like when she talked to Quentin, it was very. And when she said the same exact stuff that, you know, totally told Ollie and stuff, it's just like, something's off about you. Like, are you a clone? Are someone wearing your face? What's going on? Are you under some kind of drugs and someone's control? Something's weird.
Wouldn't be the first time that happened.
No, it wouldn't be the first time. But no, something is definitely off with her. Definitely.
Yeah, that's for sure. What was I going to say? Something about... Oh, yeah.
But I was surprised that Susan actually, after she got fired, came clean with Ollie about everything that she had on him.
Did she?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, she did. That's right, she did.
I was surprised. So it's like, what's she going to do now?
Yeah. So... Yes, they were being barfy earlier. I was in the beginning of the episode. I was like, "Oh God!" But she was like, "Are you the Green Arrow?" And Ollie said, "Yes." And I'm like, "Are you kidding,
oh, God?"
As soon as that happened, I was like, "This is a dream sequence."
Right? So, wake up!
Oh my God! But then he's like,
"It just came out of his mouth so fast."
Yes, and he tried to play it off. Like, oh my God, Ollie, why? Why?
But I don't know. I don't know. Did she really start to care for him? And
no.
This was making her mad? I know, but I'm just saying. She's so weird.
Yeah. But the thing is, okay, so she asks him if he's the Green Arrow. And then she says no. And then if Thea thinks she's trying to protect him, why would she attack her so close to when she asked? Because clearly that's a yes. You know, that's the answer, yes.
Mm-hmm.
When you get taken down like that. So I really don't know what Thea was thinking.
Like I said, it's weird. Like, it doesn't
match.
It doesn't feel like Thea. It doesn't feel like something she would do without... I mean, granted, she did go to...
She really doesn't like her, though. She doesn't.
But she did go to Felicity.
Which I was like, oh my God, why would you go to Felicity?
Right? But Thea's always talked to... doesn't matter. She doesn't care what Ollie says or thinks about what she says. She tells him like it is, and if he doesn't like it, either she'll do it anyways or she'll think about it. It's either or. And not her not going to him about this is a little suspicious, I have to say, about what she found anyways. You know, and the first person she goes to is Felicity.
Yeah.
Because I know that if she probably if she told Ollie what she found when she hacked her email, I'm pretty sure Ollie would have been like, show me. Show me everything that you found, kind of thing.
Yeah. And also... Also, what's suspicious is Thea's like, oh, I want you to put some files on her computer. And Felicity does it without looking at the files. Like, why would you just put stuff on somebody's computer and not look at them? That was weird to me, too. I was like, what? Why?
Because Felicity doesn't like her either. But
yeah, but...
I don't think Felicity is questioning, because she's never had to really question Thea before, because Thea's never really done something this, I guess, when Laura is devious before.
Unless she's Felicity's never done Prometheus.
And I mean, fucking...
Yeah, no.
We're gonna find out there's like 70 people that are Prometheus, and it's just like a freaking I'm Spartacus thing. Like, I am Prometheus. I am Prometheus.
I think Curtis did better at the fight than she probably would have. And he was just laying there letting the two girls beat up on him.
Unless Curtis is Prometheus.
No. I don't.
They've been in the same room together. Yeah. However, Thea has not.
Yeah.
She was on her... But, I don't know, maybe she hired someone. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. I don't think it's her, because Dom got a good look in the butt.
If I had the time...
I'm never going to live that down.
I would go back, I would watch every episode and be like, these are the people who have never been in the same room as Prometheus. Like, if I had the time, but I have... adult things to do.
I'm pretty sure it's just like Thea and Lance. That's probably about it.
Yeah, you're right, because Lance, which we can't rule him out yet.
No.
Yeah, I don't know. Because has Felicity been in the same room as him?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
No, I don't believe she was, but she was on comms with them.
She was on the computer.
Well,
so that's pretty.
Shit.
Yeah, that doesn't. But
they showed her a computer.
Yeah.
If we knew she was right. Okay.
Yeah. So.
If we knew she was at the computer, then she wouldn't be.
Yeah, she was at headquarters.
All right. Anyway.
So all we know is Thea's acting really weird.
Yeah.
And Susan McBitch face is gone. I have a feeling that we're not going to see.
Oh, I know she's coming back.
I was going to say I have a feeling it's not the last we're seeing or something.
Yeah.
Up.
Because here's the thing. She asks Ollie, are you the Green Arrow? Then she gets the hack job. The hack job. What does she call it? Hatchet job. So
which she called him out on. Like, oh, it's a coincidence that, you know. Yeah, no. It's not.
Yeah, so whether or not she believes Ollie that he had nothing to do with it doesn't matter, because it gives her cause to try down the line to make this stuff public. She is not taken seriously as a journalist right now. That doesn't mean she can't rebuild her reputation, or at least enough to give it to another reporter for them to report on. So it's coming back.
Something's gonna happen.
It's coming back.
But of course, it's gonna be switched around, and then no one's gonna ever know that it was him.
Mm.
See it coming, but, you know.
I don't know. If we really
are,
how
are they get out of this?
If we exactly, yeah, if we really are, like, if we can see the end of this show, you know, him being outed might be
no, not into the show. Knock on wood.
What?
Knock on wood. Not into the show.
I think I would go for an early end to the show than an end of Blake Supernatural. I hear the season's good, but what I'm saying is I don't want 5 bad seasons before we get a good season again. That's what I mean.
I disagree that it had 5 bad seasons. I think it only had 1. I think it only had 1, but the Leviathans.
Which one?
The Leviathans. But,
oh my god, 9 was so much worse.
No, but...
Yes.
For... For this, I do agree. I think it should have an early end, and I would not be opposed to it ending next season, as long as they were going to continue Ollie's character in some way in the shared universe. Throw Ollie on, you know, Legends. Send him on that team or whatever for a while. Or do, because we've been hinting a lot of Justice League stuff. Like, start a Justice League show. You know, or anything
honestly,
like that.
I don't think this universe needs a Justice League show. I think it needs a Justice League that can pop around.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't disagree. I'm just trying to find ways that would incorporate more Ollie.
It needs a watchtower.
Justice League would be that. Yeah, watchtower.
It needs a floating. It needs a floating fucking satellite base. In orbit.
Mm-hmm.
Need it.
There was something that John Barrowman posted. He's flying to Palm Springs from Vancouver. And someone asked him about him being back on Arrow. And he's like, no, I'm flying back now. Basically, he flew back because he shot a couple scenes. When exactly those are, we don't know.
But he's been on Legends.
Right.
Yep. Why would you have to, confused?
I think the Legends set is not on the same set as Flash.
Oh, okay. Never mind then.
Yeah.
Because it seems like Legends actually goes around to like some kind of location shooting. Not too much, but I feel
unlike
like
the Flash that the African jungle is in the tundra of Canada.
Okay, yeah. Okay, he said he flew in for one season, so it was one scene, so it was just one night. He flew in and blah, blah. And someone goes, oh, shame it's your last. He goes, it's the end of the season. There's always next season.
Mm.
So, don't know. So, I mean, they've already, and I've seen other places that they've been hitting around another four-way, but more heavily on Supergirl.
Yeah.
So, they have plans.
Yeah,
they have lots of plans, and these people. I mean, they're hinting, but they're not giving real specifics. You know what I mean? It's like you can theorize what's going to happen.
I don't know. They're all shot in Vancouver, apparently. So I don't know. I don't know why he would have to fly in to do that.
He flew in to do one scene. He lives in Palm Springs, and sometimes.
Oh, okay. I see. So maybe he was done filming the Legend stuff and then flew in for the...
Yeah, maybe.
For the,
Yeah.
Whatever.
He was done with the Legends stuff for the season. Flew in for one night to shoot one scene and then flew out.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know. I mean, they're hinting that it was Arrow, but there was no really, like, concrete. But why would... There's no other... show he would just fly in for when, you know, that he's majorly on. I mean, I don't think he's made an appearance in The Flash, has he?
No,
I didn't think so. So that'd be the only other show, unless they had to do a retake in Legends, but I don't think so.
Supergirl? No.
Maybe.
Maybe their Earth has another John Barrowman.
Oh, God, too?
There is no Earth 1 doppelgangers in the entire of Earth 38 except for John Barrowman. Mm-hmm. And right? He is John Barrowman, the actor.
That'd be hilariously funny.
He is not Malcolm Merlyn. Born in Scotland. Anyway.
So there's that.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I follow him. Like, what's going on? What's happening? Or maybe, I don't know, like, someone said that one of you, I don't remember, what if he was an older Malcolm Merlyn?
Yeah. Yeah, because we were talking about how it couldn't be him because he's in Legends, but if he's with time travelers, he is a time traveler, so.
Yeah.
I think my favorite part of this episode got like no time it was Dinah and Quentin.
Yeah.
But that was such an amazing interaction between them two.
Yeah. And Felicity gives her the Black Canary mask. I like that Felicity's ideas, like, just a little bit. Just a little bit at a time, like, you know.
Next week, you can have one of the gloves.
There's no shoes, just a mask.
Yeah, that was so funny. It's a mask. Like, she looked at it, like, expecting there to be shoes, and it's a mask. Like,
yeah.
Yeah,
right. Next week, you get one glove, and then if you're good, you get the other glove.
If you're good. But she's not so sure about it, you know.
Yeah, I mean, it's big shoes to fill.
It is big shoes, and she doesn't want to step on that because it is.
Well, she can't. She doesn't have shoes, so.
Well,
she's got no shoes. She fights barefoot.
No shoes.
Yeah,
but you know what I mean.
The barefoot canary.
The barefoot, but she's just worried about. I think she's mostly worried about what Lance is about.
Yeah, and he said, you know. You're not filling her shoes. You're carrying on for her, and that's what Laurel wanted.
You're not replacing her.
Yeah. Exactly. You're not replacing her. So I thought that was great. And
I see
Dinah wearing the whole costume really soon.
Yeah. Well, definitely by the end of the season, 100%. Sure. But I'd give it maybe 2 or 3 more episodes, to be honest.
Yeah, which this episode got me thinking. I'm like, where did all of my fighting ladies go? You know, Thea's not fighting anymore. We lost Artemis. Like, I'm just upset. I'm like, where are all my women? and it's like, we haven't even heard from Artemis. Like, I'm sitting here these, like, last 10 episodes, like, oh, it's gotta be, like, a long con. Like, she'll come back to us. Where is she? It's driving me crazy. She's dead in a ditch somewhere, probably. Mm. I'm upset.
Yeah.
You're upset.
But, I mean, at least the captain came around this episode. You know, it wasn't like an overarching thing that lasted, you know, a bunch of episodes and started getting us aggravated. It was literally an episode. So
But we find ourselves in another awkward spot where... Well, Ollie's probably going to get impeached, and you know which side the chief is going to fall on, because the captain's going to fall on, because it was probably him who said, yo, something's up.
Yeah, and then when Ollie said the same exact thing, or the arrow said the same exact thing that Ollie said, he's like, well, the mayor said the same thing. I'm like, dude, he's going to start connecting the dots, you motherfucker.
I know!
I mean, would it be so bad for Ollie's identity to be revealed?
No. Yes, but no. It would change the show, but it wouldn't. I don't think it would necessarily end it or put it to a stop.
Right.
You know?
So I'm saying if next season is the last season, I would like a full season of Ollie revealed as the Green Arrow, then like the finale of the final season to be Ollie revealed. And then we're sitting there going, well, what does that mean? And then we have to like get piecemeal from other shows, you know, kind of like telling that story.
I think,
and I'm not saying this show is in any danger of being canceled, but in terms of story and where they want to take their unified DC universe, I feel like Arrow is moving away from that direction, because you're seeing all the other shows. Like, Arrow's the only show that is super serious like this. You look at Supergirl, you look at Flash, you look at Legends, and there is a huge element of humor and campiness to all of them. And Arrow is the only one that is just super serious. There are jokes. I'm not saying they're not.
Yeah, no, I know.
But it's the only one that feels too serious at times.
There's always been something about Arrow that, while yes, it's very serious, there has always been this like weird campiness to it.
Yeah.
Like almost like unintentional, but perfect. We can't be in serious. I don't know.
It's just like, you see these characters too, because I just rewatched a couple episodes of The Flash season 1 on Netflix just recently, and you had Diggle the first time he met Barry, and he just goes, I had a cousin who got struck by lightning. He just developed a stutter. And it's just like, you know, it's just like you see all these things that, like, you can't imagine Diggle saying on this show and getting away with.
Well,
you know,
said it before when they did the crossovers and stuff like that. It's like when they get on these other shows, they're allowed to be funny and they're allowed. But I think since Arrow was kind of the first show, they wanted it to be this dark and mysterious kind of thing. But then they got to the other shows, and they're like, let's not do that anymore.
Well, with Diggle, with Diggle, he doesn't get that way unless he's around Barry or metahumans. Because even in, like, Arrow episodes where he's around metahumans, he's like, that's not right. That's not right.
Yeah.
But, you shouldn't be able to go that fast. That's not right.
They're always, if you notice when they're on the other shows, they're always a lot funnier and a lot more laid back and relaxed and kind of, you know, humorous and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot more than they are on this show. Which that's why I was thinking when they first came up with the Arrow, they were like, I want to be a dark, you know, because there's this guy that he's mysterious because he's been a go away for 5 years on the island and, you know, blah, blah, blah. He's all mysterious. And then when they started the other ones, they're like, they're pretty much they're more straightforward. There was no darkness kind of thing.
I don't know about you guys. I thought season one was hilarious.
I don't know.
Anyway. Last thing we have to talk about is the flashbacks. So Anatoly's gives the little speech about the Sin Eater. And I liked that in this episode, you know, you think Anatoly's Prometheus?
No.
Yeah, right.
The Sin Eater.
The Sin Eater's Prometheus?
Mm-hmm.
I think the metaphor was the Sin Eater was Ollie. At least for the episode.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because he keeps trying to take responsibility.
Still does.
Still does. Still will. He's Ollie. But the reference, you know, that ran through the show, the theme, was the Sin Eater. That, you know, they take the sins of other people. And I like that it was said before it was said in the present, you know? We've had a couple flashbacks this season where... It's said in the present, and then, like, later in the episode, it's said in the flashbacks, and that just throws me off.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's, like, the writing, if it's the editing, it's where they're putting it, but it's just felt weird to me, and it's like, this episode, I'm like, oh, this is how it's supposed to be. We hear about it from the past flashback first, and then we hear it in the episode proper, and it's like, that feels better. It just feels better. I don't know. Yeah. Anybody else feel that way? It's just me.
I guess because the flashback is supposed to be before, you know, so you should be hearing it before, but I mean, I guess it's just the way it's delivered. You may have had issues with it being done in reverse order because it just didn't come off as well. Can't recall any circumstances off the top of my head, but
I think I don't know if I got around to mentioning it. It was one of the ones with, I don't even know now. Let me see the episode titles. Maybe that'll help me.
I don't know. I love all the scenes with Anatoly. I love them.
Yeah.
I really like him.
Yeah, Anatoly's fucking hilarious.
He is.
Like, he will shoot you one day, but then smile at you the next.
Mm.
Yeah, right. And I knew something was up with the orderly when they first saw him walking by. I was like, something's going to be up with it. And then Ollie pointed it out. I'm like, oh, okay. So I wasn't just being hyper sensitive and paranoid about shit.
Yeah.
What if Vigilante is Quentin? We were saying Prometheus because they tried to throw us off base with Prometheus. You know when when Vigilante was introduced?
Yeah.
The episode where Quentin also went to rehab.
That could possibly be it.
When he was introduced?
Yeah.
The thing about it is, though, Quentin's not, that doesn't feel like Quentin. Like, he wouldn't grab a machine gun and just, like, fucking open fire and stuff.
I could see him doing that and being pissed off what happened to Laurel and what's happening. And he has expressed that Ollie should just kill people in the past because, you know.
Yeah, but he doesn't want to kill every bad guy. Just the ones that are the most dangerous.
I don't know. I just, yeah, it's a good theory. What if he is Vigilante?
I feel like they were trying to throw us off with Quentin and Prometheus that leaves the door of possibilities, because it would be too obvious if Quentin was Prometheus at the time, like the way they did it, and then revealed, oh, you know, whatever he really is. It's too obvious because you already pointed that out. And I feel like it was like a red herring to throw us off. But I don't know. I still think it's the D.O.
D.A. is Prometheus, and he knows Quentin is vigilante. That's why he did it. So there you go.
Could be.
It makes sense.
And then Vigilante was gone for a while, too, and then he comes back right around the time Quentin gets out.
It's true.
That's true, because we haven't seen him in a... Wait, hold on. Yeah, you're right. He popped up like 2 episodes ago.
Mm-hmm.
That's when Quentin came back. And Quentin is a little different than he was before. I mean, he's the same, but he's different.
Yeah.
He kind of takes no shit now, kind of thing. So, I mean, never it's did, quite but... possible. Yeah. But now he's a little less logical about shit than he was before. Before it was all by the book. I have to do this thing, but now it's like, okay, whatever.
Yeah.
So. It's quite possible. If that's it, then I guess we called it, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
We'll call it on this day, the 27th of February. Prometheus is the DA and Vigilante's Quentin, right?
Prometheus is everyone. We are Prometheus.
We are Prometheus. I am Prometheus.
I am Prometheus.
I don't want to be Prometheus. I don't look good in tight leather. I gotta put all that powder on just to get into the pants. It's messy.
Uh-huh. Okay.
It doesn't breathe right.
Yeah. I that's all I have to talk about. Mm-hmm. I mean, I guess the flashbacks kind of ended abruptly because Gregor was trying to kill Anatoly, and that was like the end of it, right? They cut away.
Gregor died, so you know.
Huh.
Don't we already know that Gregor got killed?
No, we don't know he's dead because Ollie danced around that. He said, "You owe me for Gregor." That's right. It. That's all he said.
Yeah.
So I kind of assumed.
I assumed too, but we don't know.
We don't know if he was killed, if Ollie killed him, if he killed himself, if it was accidental, if he got put in jail, if you know he got caught. We don't know anything. You know.
It could be anything.
But, you know, the one thing I keep popping up in my head, you know, like you said, he has this team that can go out and do things. Curtis needs to work on his shit.
Mm-hmm.
Curtis!
He was laying there like a turtle on his back and these girls were kicking him.
Curtis is the switch hitter. Curtis has not hit his stride because he doesn't have his gadgets. Like, he's not using his gadgets, he's trying to use his fists. It's like, Curtis... Change your wheels. Like, just get it together.
Well, like you said, he told Dog, he's like, if I would have done that, I would have broke my wrist.
Yeah. Yeah. He can fight. He can defend himself, but that's not his strength. Going up against trained fighters, he needs his gadgets. He needs Iron Man, less Luke Cage.
Yeah. I was laughing so hard, though. See, he's a girl like this, and they're just kicking.
He needs to be more Iron Man.
Poor Curtis.
We already explored that. We already explored that where he's like, I'm best, you know, behind the scenes.
Yeah.
It's like, it's your girl. Just put them together. You can do both. So I don't know when that's actually going to catch up. Maybe that's going to be a...
He's just there for the
end of the season right thing.
Now. He's there for the comic relief right now.
It's like the Black Canary costume, so I don't know.
Yeah.
Next episode, Fighting Fire with Fire. Vigilante attacks Mayor Queen. Oliver faces his biggest challenge yet as mayor. Felicity continues down her dark path with Helix. After Vigilante attacks Oliver while he's acting as the mayor, Diggle leads the team in a mission to stop Vigilante once and for all.
Dun, dun, dun.
That was abrupt. I'm sorry. I expected it to go on forever, as all these CW show synopses do. But I forgot to mention another thing I loved about this episode was Ollie solved the problems as the mayor. Good job. I like
how
when he does
that. How
much
longer that's going to be able to last? you know?
Not much longer.
No. He's gonna get impeached.
Something.
Probably. I mean, that's pretty freaking damning evidence, so.
Well, realistically, I don't know, does he really have evidence except for hearsay?
I think before he gets impeached, he's going to reveal himself, I think.
Yeah. I think the fact that there is a falsified document that can be traced back to the mayor's office.
Yeah.
I don't know. They're still not getting the full circle, the full information, you know, that Billy was dressed up like Prometheus. He was tied up. He was hanging out all this shit.
Well, of course. But so, part of that was because of Ollie and the DA.
Sure.
Which is exactly the situation they've gotten themselves in. That cover-up is traced back to the mayor's office now.
Mm-hmm.
What makes me just think the DA is Prometheus all over?
Ollie asked him to do it, though. So
he would know. He would know all this stuff, so it kind of gives credit to that.
Yeah. Or Quentin.
I don't know.
Yes, we'll see.
Yeah. Dom, where can people find you?
Find me down below at Phenomenom. PhenomeDom.
Phenomenom. Rachel, where can they find you?
They can find me at Twitter at VikingWitch76.
You can find me at... I'm sorry. Okay. You can find me at Gliomoto on Twitter, Twitch, Pinterest, WordPress, and YouTube. You can find all of us at ASO TV Podcast on Facebook, Twitter, Gmail, Google+, and right here on YouTube. Like, just Google us. I mean, we'll pop up somewhere. Follow us for some more podcasts from some of your favorite TV shows, video games, movies, whatever. Unboxings of weird things. Till next time.
Weird things.
Rip can unbox my ice cream. That'd be weird.
Ice cream?
You said weird things.
Oh.
That would be weird.
It would be weird.
I'm gonna unbox this cookies and cream ice cream.
Can I unbox some Girl Scout cookies?
So as long as they're Thin Mints.